Hey guys, welcome to a new video. I'm really happy to have you here. Before we begin the lesson, I will ask you to leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you want to support me and help me continue making this content. I also have a new newsletter, the link's in the description. I send cool links that I find throughout the week. I also share some things such as videos and blog posts, and my upcoming free course on test-driven Laravel is going to be released there first. So today I am going to talk about dependency injection and how to use the container and what is a container. We are going to use Laravel in the examples, but this is not limited to PHP or Laravel. This is a general programming concept, the container as well, and you can use it in basically any language. It's a core concept that you should know. So I already have a simple app, the same one that I used on the last video, but we are going to start from scratch. So let's jump into the code. Okay guys, so let's take a look at the code. I just have a single controller running on an index page, and this controller kind of emulates a payment. So we instantiate a payment service and we call the pay method with a user. I've created this user in the database, and with an amount of 100. And if we go here, we can see that we have the user, the amount. We instantiate a new Stripe class. We use that Stripe class to pay this amount, and then we create a payment model, a payment object. This is pretty simple. Payment just has a relationship to user, so a user has many payments. And if we go and run this, you can see that we get a new payment. We have the ID, we have the amount, we have the user ID, and we have the payment ID. Now, this is not a real Stripe class. If we go and see, it just returns a little array with some information, and we're just using it. So if we take a look at this, it's fine. And if you don't know, I am using the invoke method because I am not specifying an action on the controller. So Laravel will look for the invoke method. So if we take a look at this, it's fine. We don't see any issues, pretty standard code. But if we go here, we can see that we are hard instantiating this Stripe class. We are using the new operator. And in many times, it's not an issue. The issue here is that we cannot swap this class. It's being hard instantiated. So if we want to maybe perform a test on this controller and we don't actually want to hit Stripe, we can do it because we cannot change this class. So let's say we want to pass a mock or a fake. We want to pass a fake class that acts as a Stripe class, kind of like this one, like a fake class. This is not the actual Stripe class, but in a real scenario, that's what I'm saying. You would pass a fake class. So you just want to test. You don't want to hit Stripe. You would pass a class that mimics Stripe, has the same API, has the same methods. But it's not Stripe, you wouldn't be hitting Stripe, and you cannot do this. And the solution for this is to use dependency injection. What is dependency injection? It's simply not hard instantiating, not doing this kind of thing. And how could we do this? Well, we could pass it as an argument on the constructor. So we could say use Stripe. So we could pass a Stripe instance here. Then we could go to the constructor and say that we expect a gateway. It's protected. And instead of doing this, we would just refer to the property. So here we are injecting a dependency. You can see it right here. We have Stripe. But if we want to pass Braintree, which we do have right here, let me change this to amount, we could pass Braintree as well. We could say, hey, make this payment with Braintree, and if we go and run, it's working. Just to show you guys something, I'm going to make a little small change. Braintree IDs are going to actually be random 64 characters. So take a look at this. If I run this, I have a really big payment ID, and if I change this back to Stripe, I go back to the small IT. And we didn't change any code in the payment service. We are just injecting a dependency for this payment service. That already solves lots of issues. For instance, you could swap the classes. You could say, hey, for some kind of users, so for users that live in Brazil, I want to use Stripe. For users that live in the US, I want to use Braintree. And you could inject different dependencies based on that. And the payment class, the payment service class, wouldn't even know. And that is dependency injection. Now, I want to talk about the container. The container is one of the most powerful features of Laravel. Of course, Laravel is not the only framework that has it. But the container is basically a class that holds information on a lot of classes. So imagine that the container is an array. So you have the container, and then you have an array. And inside that array, you have lots of classes. For instance, you have the payment class, you have the bus class, you have lots of classes. Laravel holds all of its classes there, and we can use the container to fetch classes for us. And you may think, why would that be useful? Why can't we just fetch it ourselves? Because when we fetch them, we are hard instantiating classes. Even here, even though I'm passing this as a dependency to the payment service class, I am using the new operator here. I'm hard instantiating it. If I were to use the container, I could instruct Laravel to deliver different classes on different scenarios. For instance, how could I use a container? For instance, we could use the resolve method. It ships with Laravel, and we can say, Laravel, please resolve the Stripe class for me. And we can pass the gateway here. And let's run it. And we still have a Stripe class. So right now, Laravel is resolving this class for us. And what it's doing is, when we say this, Laravel checks and see if the container has this class. The container doesn't have this class, so it instantiates it and returns it to us. So it's pretty much doing the same thing that we usually do. But the reason why it's useful to instantiate classes like this is because in the future, if you want to change this implementation, you can do it. If we go to our service provider, we have this really useful method called bind. And we can say, we are talking to the container right here with the bind method. We can say container. Whenever someone wants the Stripe class, actually give them the Braintree class. Let's try this. And you can see that we get a Braintree payment. And if we go on Tinker and run resolve app, let me check the namespace, gateways, Stripe, it gives us a Braintree object. So you might be thinking, why would you do this? Why would you change a Stripe class for a Braintree class? Well, you wouldn't do it normally. What you can do is say, Laravel, instead of resolving a Stripe class, a concrete class, resolve me an interface. So we could say, we can see that both Stripe and Braintree implement the payment gateway interface. And we can say, give me the payment gateway interface. And let's see what happens. Well, it fails because we cannot instantiate this. We cannot instantiate an interface. However, if we instruct Laravel to instantiate it how we want, we can do it. I have this code commented out. And what we are saying is, Laravel, whenever someone requests the payment gateway class through the container, give them the Stripe class. And let's run it. And now we get a Stripe payment. And this is really useful. Let's say you are, I don't know, let's say you're testing this class and you want to use your fake payment gateway. On your test, you can say, hey, Laravel, when someone requests the payment gateway, give them my fake gateway. And Laravel would do this. It would give you the fake gateway. But the container does not stop there. We're using the resolve method here. But we can go even further and we can get rid of this, and resolve it through the container. So you might be thinking, well, there's no difference here. It's going to throw an error. We don't have a gateway here. We are expecting a gateway. How are we going to solve this? So you see that it's missing a parameter. We don't have this one. It's not injecting the dependency. What Laravel does have is auto-fetching dependencies, auto-injecting dependencies. See, right here, we are resolving the payment service class with the container. We are using the resolve method. That means that the container is responsible for getting us this class. That also means that the container has access to the constructor. And we can type hint this and let Laravel automatically give us a dependency. So we can say, Laravel, I want Stripe here. Let's try. And it works. So we are saying Laravel checks and says, okay, so this payment service class expects a gateway parameter, but it didn't receive anything. What should I do? And it sees that we have time hinted a Stripe class and it automatically fetches this for us. We can go even further. And if you don't know, controllers are also fetched through the container. So yeah, that's right. It's what you think. We can get rid of this. And we can say that we want the payment service and we want Laravel to inject it for us. And here we just change it to use the property. Let's run it. And it's still working. So we've changed this all to use dependency injection. You can either use it on the constructor on classes that are resolved by Laravel. If we were to instantiate this class, the payment service class, using the new keyword, it wouldn't work because PHP does not know that it needs to inject the Stripe class. This is a feature of Laravel, and you have this on other frameworks. Symfony has it, Xen has it, I think, and on other languages as well. Now, this is already plenty useful. You can do a lot of things with this. You can even fake a payment service. You can fake a payment service, you can fake a gateway, and as it's all resolved through the container, so you can just swap this on a container level and Laravel will give you the desired implementation. And look, we are passing the Stripe class here, but as I said, let's change this to pass a contract. So let's pass a payment gateway interface. Let's go to our app service provider and say that we want to bind the payment gateway interface to our Stripe class. And we now have the default binding. It works. Now, take a look at this. Let's say your app runs in the countries that I mentioned, Brazil and the US, and you want to run Stripe in Brazil and Braintree in the US. What you can do is you could pass a closure here, an anonymous function. And you could say something like that. If app, let's do something like if app country is Brazil, we want to return a Braintree instance. I'm sorry, a Stripe instance. Otherwise, we want to return a Braintree instance. Let's run it. So we are getting a Braintree. If we go to Tinker, let me refresh this, and resolve our payment gateway class. What? Oh, it's missing. It's in the wrong namespace. Contract. We are getting a Braintree. But if we go and add this country variable and say br, we are now getting a Stripe instance. So this is just a little bit of what the container can do. You can do lots of things here. You can return different instances of things regarding based on different configs, based on the user configuration. You have lots of options. So let's just change this first to Stripe for now. And that's it, guys. So we are saying that we are expecting a payment gateway instance. And we are telling Laravel to return us a Stripe instance. Now, this type hint is still valid, so we still must receive a payment gateway instance. In this case, a class that implements this contract. if we go and tell Laravel to inject Stripe, but if we remove this from Stripe, it's going to fail. So it requires an instance of payment gateway, but we gave Stripe. If it implements the contract, it works. So this is really useful when you have multiple implementations of something, for instance, of a payment provider, of a SMS provider, or if you want to test your classes and you need to swap implementations. You can use dependency injection for this, and you can leverage the container to help you on this. So this is it, guys. Thanks for watching. If you've liked this video, you can share it with your friends, you can like it, and you can follow me on Twitter, subscribe to the channel, all of that stuff. See ya. Thanks for watching. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.